Welcome back to Daily Flash. Here's Fabian Marcano with this week's The Beat.
What's up, guys? Over the weekend in Nashville, Tennessee, a city filled with frequent celebrity-studded events, it marks a momentous occasion to bring together more than a dozen members of the Country Music Hall of Fame. Titans of the country music gathered to help welcome three more artists into the fold, artists Patti Loveless and Tanya Tucker, as well as songwriter Bob McDill, bringing the number to Country Music Hall of Fame members to 152 estimated artists who are now part of the coveted club. All about Bob McDill this last weekend, who proved himself to be one of the most skilled songcrafters in the genre's history, contributing numerous hit songs to country's music canon. Don Williams recorded over 30 of McDill's songs, like Amanda and It Must Be Love, while McDill also wrote Keith Whitley's Don't Close Your Eyes, Alabama's Song of the South, Dan Seals' Everything That Glitters Is Not Gold, and Alan Jackson's Gone Country. Bobby Bear recorded an entire album worth of McDill's composition in 1997. In 2017, McDill donated 217 legal pads of notes and lyrics to the Country Music Hall of Fame and Museum. On Sunday evening, McDill was inducted into the Hall of Fame songwriter category, obviously, by fellow Country Music Hall of Famer and the gambler, writer Don Shields. Golden Voice Kentucky native Patti Loveless was inducted in the Modern Era Artist category. Loveless started out as a family duo with her brother Roger, and while still in her teens had earned the encouragement of Porter Wagoner and Dolly Parton, and already had earned a slot touring with Wilburn Brothers, okay? After earning her first Billboard Hot 100 song, Top 10, in 1988 with a cover of George Jones' If My Heart Had Windows, Loveless went on to earn more than 30 top 20 country songs, including 5 chart toppers. In accepting the honor, of visibly emotional Loveless honored her late brother Roger, who died last year, and who had a long bandmate and champion for Loveless since the two were kids singing together as a duo singing Swinging Rammies. And Tanya Tucker made her debut in 1972 as a little 13-year-old talent with a top 10 hot country songs hit with Delta Dawn, and swiftly went on to notch the 6 number one country songs hits before she turned 18 songs with mature themes that helped redefine the boundaries for women in country music. She's etched her reputation as a magnetic rock and roll inspired entertainer and commanding hit maker. After 3-year hiatus from recording, she returned to country music spotlight, earning 24 top 10 country songs from 1986 through 1997. Accepting her honor, Tucker called her journey of the Hall of Fame a 52-year experience, and I've had lots of ups and downs. She thanked her 3 children who were in attendance, as well as members and management, touring teams, and her paid her tribute to her father and early manager, Bill Tucker. And she recalled sitting with her father watching a Grand Ole Opry performance when she was just a child, and hearing her father say, "Now, don't you wish that you were up there doing it instead of just sitting here watching it?" And she said, "Yes, sir, I do. From that moment on, I've never been a good audience member, and I haven't been a good one today," she said, referencing her moments joining Coulter Price and Carlisle on stage during their performances. After getting a fist look at the bronze plaque that commemorates her induction into the Hall of Fame and the plaque that will hang in the Country Music Hall of Fame and Museum's Rotunda, Tucker again thanked the audience. She tosses it her Elvis-esque white bejeweled jacket over her shoulder. Tucker walks off the stage with Winona soon returning center stage to lead the audience in what becomes the customary closure for the evening, a sing-along of Will the Circle Be Unbroken. From there, the gathered music industry denizens walked upstairs in the Country Music Hall of Fame for an after-ceremony party to further celebrate the hall's newest members. That's all you got today on The Beat. I'm Fabian Marcano, so be sure to check us out on Daily Flash Latino and head to our website to check out our local listings and times, dailyflashlatino.com.